Hallelujah.
Amen.
God bless you wherever you are. As you are watching us, believe that you are blessed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And God bless those of you that are supporting this program. May God richly bless you more. In Jesus' mighty name. As the word of God is coming your way today, believe that there will be a transformation in your life. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus. Amen. unto your name. Glory be unto your name, Jesus. Forever you are the King, the I am that I am. We praise your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. We are going to dance unto the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Wherever you are, just like and share the program. Like and share. God bless you.
Before we continue, I want to greet my pastors.
President Johnson, Adika,
my greetings to our President Johnson Smith Adika. And the vice in Togo, Aboti Nyame. To our pastor, Michael Dogbefu at Komoedua. And also to those in Accra. May God strengthen you. And be with you.
Amen.
Amen.
Le mau kwenye anwa bedasi ke mau chana mwe be mia akulonye bedasi sito tipu.
The message that God has given me is entitled The Message from Heaven.
Bedasi sito tipu.
The Message from Heaven.
Bedasi sito tipu la zigelena amagadomo kona tisa.
The message from heaven, most of the time we don't believe it.
Eh amono kono bana nuhu bona
and at times when you tell people that the end is coming, they don't believe. What I want to tell the whole church is that as we are closer to the end time, each and everyone that is reading the word or listening to the word or preaching the word, we have to meditate upon the word very well. We have to understand it. We have to open our eyes in order that we can preach the truth and do the will of God. Brethren, I want to tell you that the end is coming. And when they say it, these people don't believe it because they have not witnessed it. And most of them don't believe. But this evening, I want to tell you that God has done his own work when Moses was alive. Jesus also came to do the 33 years work and he's gone. And right now, the Holy Spirit is doing its work. And that is the last. Because we have God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And the Father has ended. The Son has done his own. Now the Holy Spirit is the one working. So I want to tell you that if the Holy Spirit has died or is finished with his work, rapture is coming. And the most important is that you and I don't know when the rapture will occur. So the Bible says we should be alert because we don't know the very hour. So this evening, I want to tell you that prepare yourself. Prepare yourself. In the word of God, believe the word of God. Have confidence in what he said. Believe it. Because Jesus has given us salvation on the cross. Say amen. I want us to go to the word. Matthew chapter 12. From verse 30 to 32. Matthew 12, 30 to 32. Whoever is not with me is against me. Whoever does not gather with me scatters. 31. Therefore I tell you, every sin and blasphemy will be forgiven, but the blasphemy against the Holy Spirit will not be forgiven. 32. And whoever speaks the words against the Son of Man will be forgiven, but whoever speaks against the Holy Spirit will not be forgiven either in these ages or the ages to come. Amen.
Amen.
Matthew Baka Baneta, we have a talk with Black on Vassar, Black on Vom and Velia. A Mexican Melly Clean Bola, a Yako for the Mutini, a Mexican Mokwa who Clean Bola, a Yakana Plena, a Yaka Mutima like a Blom Nami Bena. What a move for Siamufo, Lopusunia, Siamusunia, Ake Ameo, Kapusunia, the Popola Mutilla, Womatue Akeo. Eh, and then a mother, a colonia, the Amequetopila Mutilla, what were Ake, K ke amesi ke agblonya de kpokpokpokwe la mutila o ma tue agele keke sia alo esi la va va la me o amen
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 nemi nemi ala nkure enya ntia.
If you take a critical look at this verse,
nemi kpokpi bi black tonia
verse 30 whoever is not with me is against me.
It's
against me.
You are
against me. If
you are
against God, what do you think will happen?
If you are
an enemy to God, what do you think will happen?
My
brethren, I want you to hear the voice of heaven. And it is saying that whosoever is not with me, whosoever does not believe in me, the work that I've done on the cross, I have taken your death and died. Jesus said he has taken our
death.
He has taken us from the power of sin. If you don't believe that, if you haven't given him your life, my brother, if you die, you are going to hell. Whether you agree or not, this is the truth. Because
that,
if you hear this, the work that you are supposed to do is to give your life to this.
Amen.
Say amen.
Keep it black of what it can.
Verse 31.
Amen.
It says,
keep it black of what it can for Brabana. I come to Malala Brabana Mibana.
He said, therefore, I tell you,
what to move for sin, move for act.
Every sin will be forgiven. And blasphemy. And blasphemy against the Holy Spirit will never be forgiven. Look here.
Say so
every blasphemy, any mistakes that we have done to God, you will be forgiven. And what you have done against Jesus, it will be forgiven. But
and
a sin against the Holy Spirit will never be forgiven. Not in this world or the world to come. Listen to this. Why is it so? If you have sinned against God, we have received forgiveness. Because Jesus came because of that. To forgive our sins. That's why our sins are forgiven. That's why he died on the cross. Brethren, the time in which we are is the Holy Spirit that is working. The Holy Spirit is working. If you don't believe in Jesus at this moment, and unfortunately you lose your life and you don't have that life, you don't have that salvation, you are going straight to hell. You are going to hell because Jesus is done with his work and the Holy Spirit is working. And we don't know the time the Holy Spirit will end. So you need to repent.
Amen.
Say amen. Brother, look here. If you
have
offended a pastor, it's not that they will not forgive you. That is not the truth. If you offend a pastor, you offend a papa, you offend a pope, you offend a prophet, you offend a prophet, it won't be forgiven. But if you are so strong hearted and you have not repented at this very moment, there is no forgiveness. There is no forgiveness. That's why you, the one listening, if you have seen yourself that you don't have Jesus in your life, stand and believe in Jesus and press closer to Jesus, and so that your sins will be forgiven. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Near God, you had it.
First John.
Johannes Baga Banabanto, Ta Aton, Toku Kuwi Atenkoyi. Ne Amada Bono Via Wonu Vong. Sim, Mahe Ame Ayi Kume O. Na De Kuku, Eye Wana Ape, Ame Sioma Wonu Vong. Si Ape Ame Ayi Kume O. Nufo Ali, Si Ape Ame Ayi Kume. De Makrobe, Wate Kuku De Eyata O. Major Ninia Tata, Enya Nufo, Eye Nufo Ali. Amen.
Amen. 1 John chapter 5, verse 16. That was verse 16 to 18. If anyone sees his brother committing a sin not leading to death, he shall ask, and God will give him life. To those who commit sins that do not lead to death, there is sin that leads to death. I do not say that one should pray for that. Verse 17. All wrongdoing is sin, but there is sin that does not lead to death. Amen.
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 The
written is saying that if you have seen a brother and has committed sin, say, plead for that person. No matter what the person has done, whether the person is a beggar, whether he is a sorcerer, no matter whoever he is, so if that person commits sin, you can plead for that person. Listen to this. It is saying that all wrongdoings are sin, so when you pray, they will forgive you. But it is saying, but there is a sin. It's not saying there are sins. He said there is a sin. I want you to understand this. He said there is a sin. That when you commit this, it will not be forgiven. In this world or the world, other world, what is that sin? And that sin, is you the one who does not believe in the death of Jesus and the resurrection of Jesus. When you die, you will not be forgiven. Because Jesus has forgiven us all sorts of sins. Even the one we have done or committed from the beginning of Adam to date, we are forgiven. So if you see sin is with you, you just plead to God and He will forgive you. But He said there is a sin. There is a sin. There is a sin. And which will never be forgiven. And that is, if you are in this life, you are a human being, and you don't believe in Jesus on the cross, what He has done over there, you don't believe that your sin has remained. Your sin has remained. And when you die, you are going to hell. So what you need is that this very moment, this is the last moment. This is the very last hour.
Look at
why are we in the last hour? It's because the Holy Spirit is the one working. If the Holy Spirit is finished with the work, then it means rapture must forget. So you need to repent in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Say amen.
Petro fait à parler tant tantôt. Choku kuwi et ni va serre blague voir et pelea. Dans la soirée, le Christ au fait tient pays pleinement tité de tamouti. Nala, elle a ben à Christ au hape pour le nouveau moutiti de ta. A me jojoué de a me major te fait. Ben à wa promis à y ma ou bon. Et si me wou wo wi le ŋuti la gome ke wo gbɔ agbe le gbɔgbɔ gome esia hã wotɔ edzi heyi eye wogblɔ nyafia gbɔgbɔwo le gaxɔme ame si se to tsã esime mawo ƒe dzigbɔgbɔ blewu la lala le nowa ƒe ŋukekewo me esime wole aɖakaʋu dzram ɖo sime woaɖe ame ʋee si le luvɔ enyi la le hetso dzime nu si nye kpɔɖeŋu na mawo tsi ɖe ɖe ta na me si ɖe miawo hã azɔ si menye ŋutilã ɖi ƒoƒo ɖeɖe ɖa o ke boŋ dzitsinya nyuie ƒe adzɔgbe ɖeɖe na mawu heto yesu kristo ƒe tsitretsitsi me ame si yi ɖe dziƒo eye wole mawu ƒe nuɖusi me eye mawu dɔlawo kple dziɖuɖuwo kpakple ŋusẽwo gbɔgbɔ wo ɖokui nɛ amen
amen ne míese petro ƒe agbalẽ gbãtɔ etatɔ bibi enyi nia
if you read this
o be yesu kristo kpe fu esipe nufɔ ƒe fu
e se jesus suffered
ekpe nufɔ si ke enye kpli wo miewɔ yesu ma kpe fu ɖe ta
e suffered for the sin that you and I committed
bawo na kpɔtɔ tɔ ke
for us to be forgiven
do to na senya
listen to this
esi yesu wu efu kpekpe nufɔ
when jesus was done with that suffering
esi wotsɔ miaƒe nufɔ wo yi ɖe atutu ga ŋutia
when he took our sins unto the cross
eku
he died
what
and was buried
le yeƒe didi ma
and through that burial
eyi le tiepe
he went to death
eyi le tiepe
he went into the spirit
eyi na
he went into the
spirit eyi le bɔni o de
he went into the gospel
eyi o va gbɔ mawu nyana ame si o kata ku hafi o va
and preach the word to all those who died before he came
ame yi o kata ku o
and all those who died
bibla gblɔ wɔ na
the bible is saying
wɔn le ka xɔ me
that they were in prison
wɔn le wɔn le ka xɔ
their spirits were in prison
luvɔ le ka
xɔ their souls were in prison
wɔn le ka xɔ me
they were in prison
wɔn le satan ƒe ga xɔ me
they were in prison of satan
wɔn na ye ne mu fa
that when the end comes
wa gblɔ ade tso na
fa they might go to hell
akele nɔfi enye mi ne tso
but you know what happened
yesu yi le wo gbɔ
jesus went there
o fa gbɔ mamu nyana o
and preached the word to them
o ma nyana me so kata la fi me
and all those who were there
ame yi o kata le nu ɔwɔli o ma kɔ jisrael
and those during the times of noah did not believe
eye tsi dɔdɔ wu o na
and the water killed them
wo fa gbɔgbɔ yi le ka xɔ me
their spirit went into prison
yesu va be yaba de wo le ka xɔ me
and jesus went there to deliver them
eye o va ye de wo le ka xɔ
me and he delivered them from
prison eye o gbɔ o de ti fo
and he said them to heaven
global amen
say amen
aya kanye jene ti ma to
that's why you need to repent
go feel that
look here
amado gona be
people will say
yeah yeah ibele ti ma to
as for me I will repent
la benu no be show la yesi
because I have worthy things
e kale yesi
I have money
akole yesi
I have houses
akole yesi
I have cars
and no mo ti ko
and you have been looking up on all those brother
but you make your
name I want to tell you
that
in the book of Revelation chapter
3
and we go to verse 15
and we
end verse at 20
nyadede fia ƒe agbalẽ ta tɔ tso kukui wi atɔ va se ɖe blave la menya wo dɔwɔwɔwo bena mefa hã o medze dzo hã o ɖe medi be ɖewo nafa alo nadze dzo ke le esi me le yɔyrɔe medze dzo eye mefa hã o ŋuti la matu wo aƒu gbe atso nye nu me elabena egblɔna be yenye kesinɔtɔ eye kesinɔnua le ye si eye naneke mehia ye o eye menye be hiãtɔ kple nublanuitɔ kple gbotɔ kple ŋkugbagbatɔ kpakple ame amama nɔla menye o mele aɖaŋu ɖom na wo be naƒle sika si wololo le dzo me la le asinye be nazu kesinɔtɔ kple avɔ ɣi bena natsɔ ne wo ŋukpeƒe nagadze o kpakple ŋkutike be nasi ɖe wo ŋkuwo be nakpɔ nu nye la ame geɖe ale si nu me nɔna la meka ŋkume na wo eye mehia tona eya ta do vevie be natrɔ le wo dzi me kpɔ ɖa mele tsitre le ʋɔtrua nu le eƒom ne ame aɖe se nye gbe eye wo ʋu ʋua la mage ɖe eme le egbɔ eye maɖu nu kpli eye eya hã aɖu nu kpli amen.
Hallelujah. Revelation chapter 3 verse 18 to 20. I know your works. You are neither cold nor hot. Would that you are either cold nor hot. So because you are lukewarm and neither hot or cold, I would spit you out of my mouth. For you say, I am rich. I have prospered. I need nothing. Not realizing that you are wretched, pitiable, poor, blind and naked. Verse 18. I counsel you to buy from me a refined gold by fire, so that you may be rich, and you may be rich, and white garments, so that you may clothe yourself, and the shame of your nakedness may not be seen, and the slaves to anoint your eyes, so that you may see. Verse 19. Those who I love, I reprove and discipline, so be serious and repent. 20. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him and eat with him. And those who conquer, I will grant him to sit with me in my throne. I also conquered and sat down with my father on his throne. Verse 22. He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me go.
So the book of Revelation chapter 3 from verse 15 to 20.
Hey, now,
he says, I know your works. You are not hot and you are not cold. I wanted you to be hot. Or I wanted you to be cold. But neither you are cold or hot. I will spit you out.
Wait and
listen to him. He said he will spit you out.
He
said you are going to say that you are rich. And you need nothing. He said, you don't know that you are blind and poor. You are someone that beats
yourself.
And here you are, and that's what I advise
you.
That you buy a medicine. And you buy a white garment. That white garment is the
garment
of righteousness. Every Christian needs that garment. If you don't have the righteousness, then you belong to
her.
May God bless you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Say amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 God bless you wherever you are. Apostle, God bless you more.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. This Evangelical Right Generation Church International, whole headquarters. We love you all. As you are watching, keep on liking and sharing. And those of you that are supporting this program, God richly bless you more. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Shalom.